You wanted a cell, Peter, and a cell you have. St. Peter Celestine. Hello, my friends, and welcome to True Heroes. Today we are going to talk about St. Peter Celestine, a monk turned pope in a rather unusual manner. Let us begin his story. So when the father of this Italian saint, because yes, once again, we have another Italian. Once the father of the saint died, his good mother brought up her 12 children, even though they were very poor. She said, quote, "Oh, if I could only have the joy of seeing one of you become a saint," unquote. Once when she asked, as usual, which one of you is going to become a saint, little Peter answered with all his heart, "Me, Mama, I'll become a saint." This is not surprising, seeing that already at his young age, so this I suppose would have been around 8 or 9 years old, Peter already regularly had visions of the Blessed Virgin Mary, as well as angels and saints, and would communicate with them regularly. When he was about 20 years old, Peter became a hermit and spent his days praying and reading the Holy Bible. If he was not praying or reading, he would copy books or do some hard work so that the devil would not find him doing nothing and tempt him. And this is key for dealing with temptation in general. The old saying is, idle hands is the devil's workshop. So someone who is not doing anything, they're just sitting around, they are lazy, it makes them a much easier target of the devil. So in order to prevent as much as one can the temptations, one should always be doing something. Something to distract the mind, something to occupy the mind, so that he is not giving the devil more opportunity to tempt him. Now, this doesn't work perfectly, right? So this did not entirely prevent the devils from trying to tempt him. During a 3-year period, the demons tempted him constantly with temptations of the flesh, but he was equally comforted and encouraged by the visits of angels. And he, in addition to this, would wear a heavy chain around his neck next to his skin so as to subject his flesh to his will. Because other hermits kept coming to him and begging him to guide them, he started a new order which would later be called the Celestines. Now, why it was called Celestines and not, say, Petrines, we will see a little bit later on. This order did eventually become a part of the branch of the Benedictines, so the order that was started by Saint Benedict. In the church he constructed for this new order, heavenly music could be heard whenever he said Mass, and unseen bells were heard from the heavens, rung by the angels. When he was an old monk, around 84 years of age, he ultimately received his heaviest cross, and it came in a very unusual way. For 2 years, there had been no pope, because the cardinals, after the death of the previous pope, had not decided on whom to choose. Now, Peter became very disgruntled and annoyed by the delay and sent the cardinals a message saying God was not pleased at the long delay. Then and there, they chose the holy old hermit himself for pope. So poor Peter wept when he heard the news, but he sorrowfully accepted and took the name Celestine V. And kind of imagine this position that must have been very odd for him, and it was odd for the church in general. You can imagine these high in position in the church, these cardinals have been arguing and voting and debating for the last 2 years, trying to select a new pope, and this old hermit comes and says, "You're taking too long, hurry up." And essentially the cardinals turned it back on him and said, "Well, fine, you do it then." He took the name Celestine, it is said, because this would help remind him of the heavenly life he was leaving in order to lead the church. So we see that he spent a lot of time talking to the saints, talking to the angels, talking to the Blessed Virgin Mary. He essentially lived in heaven. The name Celestine, of course, comes from the Latin Caelis, which means heaven. So that is why he picked that name. He was Pope only for about 4 or 5 months. Because he was so humble and simple, everyone took advantage of him. He could not say no to anyone, and soon matters were in great confusion. At last, the saint decided that he had better give up his position as Pope, and he did so, and then threw himself at the feet of the cardinals for not having been capable of governing the church. None of the cardinals held this against him at all. And of course, he did have a right to step down, especially when he saw that the church was in such great confusion, and it was because of, at least in this case, his poor leadership skills. Saint Peter Celestine hoped to live in one of his monasteries in peace, but the new pope thought it would be safer to keep him where wicked people could not take advantage of him. You know, so they won't try to get him to speak out against the new pope or anything like that. The saint was put in a cell and died there, yet he was cheerful and close to God. And at his death, a bright cross was seen above the door of his cell. He would say to himself, quote, "You wanted a cell, Peter, and a cell you have," unquote. He was canonized by Pope Clement V just 11 years after his death. From the life of St. Peter Celestine, let us learn humility. Let us recognize our place in the world, however small that place may be. St. Peter went from being a hermit who lived mostly in solitude, unknown by pretty much anyone, to being a pope, and so naturally recognized by everyone, and then right back down again to living in solitude and being forgotten by everyone. He always accepted that position, though, no matter what position it was at the time, until God made it obvious to him that his position had to change. And how ready are we to accept our own positions and the changes that take place? Usually we're a little bit more bitter and frustrated than he probably was. So let us accept these changes and our position in life and praise God for them. Tomorrow is the feast of Saint Bernardine of Siena, who was a Franciscan preacher whose success as a preacher was prophesied by Saint Vincent Ferrer before him. Tomorrow is also the feast, it's also the vigil of the Ascension, so let us take this opportunity now then to prepare as far as we are able, depending on where you are and what is allowed in your state, to prepare our souls for our Lord's entrance into heaven. Until then, God bless you all, my friends. Saint Peter Celestine, pray for us.